Aside from Turkey, usually the winter we have here is north, northeast. On their shores, the winds coming from the mainland. For 1 or 2 miles, the weather is calm, the sea is calm. So they say, okay, no problem, we will continue. Yeah. But after when they leave 2 or 3 miles from the coast and they see the real weather, it's impossible for them to turn back. So they continue with any force. Usually, that's when we have the big accidents, and that's when we have the big number of loss. As you saw, they were wearing life vests. The life vests is a very cheap imitation, and you saw maybe some of them were riding on Yamaha. At the beginning, we were saying, they pay too much money, they buy Yamaha life vests, very good. But they are a very cheap imitation, they were buying them from Turkey for 15, 20 euros. They are not really designed, they are not SOLAS certified from the SOLAS convention that they can keep afloat, because a life vest SOLAS certified must keep a person, even if it is unconscious, with the neck and the head above the sea, so he will not get drowned. Those very cheap imitations, usually they couldn't, not even for 10 minutes, keep afloat a person. That's why we were finding many bodies wearing life vests. They were being drowned with life vests because the life vests couldn't control the human weight. That's tragic. And they were selling them 20 euros. They were paying $1,000 for the transportation and over 20. Also, another situation is that you see how they were stuck inside the boat. Because you gain bigger numbers, they even tried them, they forced them without not to take many bags with them, so they can gain more space for it. They usually put in the center of the boat women and children, and they put the women, the legs like this. They stack them like sardines in a can. They are very good at that. They calculate every centimeter. They put like this, the opposite women, they put their legs like this. On their legs, they put usually the babies, and around the external perimeter of the boat, they put the men. So many times when we find a boat like this, women cannot stand up. You can see they are paralyzed, and they say, help, 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 because their legs are so forced with the children on, and because of the small space, and they cannot move. You have to give them some minutes, or to drag them, 2 persons for us to drag them, or some minutes to, you know, so that the blood, the circulation will come again. They don't leave them, they don't allow them to take big baggages with them. And,
Do they have water?
Usually don't have water. Maybe they have 1 or 2 bottles, but they don't have water. They don't take any, because they know that the journey is only maybe maximum 1 hour, so they know that maybe the usual water will not be necessary. When we take them up, we try to give them first aid, we try to give them water, blankets, we try to provide them as many things as is possible for us, okay, because it's very difficult. Usually our patrol boat is only 4 persons crew, and we have to handle 70 or maybe, like the one you say, 140 people. It's not easy. But believe me, we have saved many kids with CPR, many kids were almost drowned, and we take them on board and we provide them CPR and resuscitation. And we managed to save some kids. We give them some water, blankets, to keep them warm, because usually in winter time, if you fall inside the sea, yes, you have the phenomenon of hypothermia. We have faced many incidents of hypothermia. And we are trained how to detect and deal with hypothermia. Because the hypothermia is very important. If you delay half an hour, maybe you will lose the patients. It's very difficult.
Many incidents.
No, there's also a video documentary that was last year was released, 4.1 miles. If you have seen it, yes.
No,
mark it down.
We saw it last year.
It came down on the YouTube channel.
Yeah.
Yes, 4.1. It was also nominated for the Oscar award winning.
It was made by Mrs.
Daphne Mazaraki. She's a Greek director, yes. And it showed in a small, in maybe a few minutes, how hard our work was the captain, the captain Kilevis Papadopoulos. We are in the same patrol boat. We are colleagues, and he is one of the most famous captains in Greek Coast Guard. I invite you to see the 4.1. It's a very good documentary. It shows the real situation and the real how our job was. Any antecedents? Believe me, I have so many experiences, so many viewings inside my mind. I could write a book with 1,000 pages for every time that we saw a boat in danger, or people in danger, or people saved, or bodies picked up from the sea. But you have to know one thing for sure. The Greek authority, the Greek Coast Guard, has one task and one task only every night, 24/7, just to save lives. That is our task. Every time that we go outside patrolling, we start, we will be prepared so that no human life will be lost during our patrol boat. It's very difficult. Believe me, it's not an easy job. But we are giving 100% of ourselves every night because we don't want, like, personally, I don't want to see another dead body on my patrol boat. I don't like that. I would do yesterday before 2 days where we were caught with eight night before wind. The big passengers were not traveling. They were forbidden to travel. And they called us and they said that we have a boat in distress, maybe here in Mytilini or maybe in Molyvos. Believe me, we didn't hesitate even for one moment. We said, okay, if it is a real situation, we will go outside in danger for our patrol boat and for our lives of the crew just to save lives. That is our duty and that is our task. And believe me, all the colleagues in the patrol boats and the colleagues from the patrol authority are very emotional, very determined in their duty. That's for sure. You must know everyone from European countries. I know you guys. I had to add also your guys also because we have an Italian boat. They share the same mentality, the same line of duty. I know for sure that they do the same thing. We are not only your colleagues also, and also the other foreign fixed assets. We have from Latvia, we had many times boats, patrol boats from Latvia. They were also helping. From Czech, we have only patrol, main land units, land surveillance units. But from other countries, we have from Croatia, they are all helping. But you have to believe it that the Greek Coast Guard were the only that was only here present all the time, and it's the main factor that conduct save and rescue operations.
I think sometimes your service is a victim of political blame games.
I'm not here to speak political because if I speak political, I'm only here to.
You know what
I know what you mean, but I cannot speak for political issues and reasons. I am a soldier. My task is
to obey.
Yes, to obey my senior officers and to serve my country. Serve my country.
We want to blame governments or countries, and the blame includes Coast Guard also.
I don't understand, but believe me, Coast Guard is. Yeah. We are the last postal instrument. We are only soldiers. We are obeying orders. You know how many times we always discuss with the refugees on board? And sometimes we ask them, why are you leaving? Especially Syrian people. Well, my friend, why are you leaving? He said, my friend, if you were in a house and every day it was bombed, you had no electricity, no water, your children were crying every night, what would you do? Would you take your children, sell everything and go and find another country? And I said to him, yes, my friend, you're right. Because every night they didn't know who would go and kill them. The Assad regime, the guerrillas, the ISIS, the DW, I don't know how many guerrillas parties they we didn't know who to trust. We didn't know who will be the one to kill us. I found many academic professors, doctors, civil engineers. Yes, very, very highly educated persons, yes. I saw one guy who had two factories in Syria. Two factories. They said they bombed one factory, and they had one factory. Then they bombed Assad bombed the first one, and the guerrillas bombed the second one. And then they said, I was destroyed. So what we were doing, what I can do in Syria? I took my family and I left. So I think for, about politicalities, they must find a solution so that war and conflicts must stop.
It's not our...
Yes, but it's not our task and Stavros and us is just to perform save and rescue operations and to give the maximum of our strength to so that no human life will be lost during the passage from Mytilini. 4.1 mile is the distance on the northern side, that was the named after that. It's exactly the distance,
the closest
point. Yes, the closest point of Mytilini and the northern side of Turkey, it's 0.1 mile exactly. You know how many immigrants, they said that they thought it was a river.
Yeah.
They were telling them, the Turkish smugglers were telling them that you will pass this river, you will pass this river, you will go to Greece.
Even in Karatepe they keep saying it.
Yes, they
river. Yes, river.
You know how many times they approached, we saved them and they say, Italy, Italy, this is Italy. We were saying, no, Italy, my friend, this is Grecia. No, Italy, but we will pay to go to Italy. Italy, my friend, is very far from here. They were fooling them. They were telling them that if you cross this river, you go to Italy. That is to see how ignorant and how they treat ignorant is the immigrants because they pay. You should know that against Turkey, opposite Turkey is Greece, not Italy. Italy is very far. But if they pay, because the smugglers say that you will go to Italy. Anyway, like the municipality representative said, you will be a correspondent to whole Europe about Mytilini. Mytilini suffered. All the local here, our citizens, fellow citizens, I'm proud of them because they showed a face of solidarity and affection and love to the immigrants. Don't forget that we also from Mytilini, we were immigrants and from the minor Asia, I'd say, from Ismini, when the destruction of Ismini, most of them, most of us, our origins are from the opposite side and we have suffered the immigration. I was also an immigrant. I was born in Australia. My parents went to Australia to immigration for a better life and they returned back, so I'm also an immigrant. So all our fellow citizens show their face of solidarity, affection and the love and help to all the... And for that, personally, I'm very proud for my townmates here.
Yeah, the island is beautiful, it's really beautiful. We have been through different places, it's one of the most beautiful places I've ever been. It happens that it is my hometown, but it is very nice. Of course, this has affected the tourism and it's normal, as we said before. But give it a chance if you have some time. All these pictures are from around the island and it deserves. The distances are big. You might need 2 hours to go to the other side of the island, but naturally, it is one of the most beautiful places in Greece, I think.
Unfortunately, the weather is not because maybe if you were 1 week before, you could swim.
No matter the swimming.
You could swim one year.
I know the island very well.
We didn't have much time because of program. So they have to come back for 10 days.
Yes. If it really needs a visit, we must have at least 10 days to visit and go to all the villages. And
I lived here for a year and it wasn't enough to see everything.
No, it's, for us also, we live here forever. There are places we haven't been and we have time to stay. We must go.
Thank you very much. It was very interesting.
Thank you.